Previously on Factions.
I see their cannon right there. I see the top of it with dispensers. 18%, 13, boom, give me that kill. Oh, this is where we finish. Oh, thanks for the bull boost. Boom, give me that kill. We've done so well today. It was a good battle. Mitch, did you have fun today, buddy?
Yeah.
See you later, buddy. See you later.
Hit the water, hit the water, hit the water. Nope. I missed. Yeah! Are you serious?
You know, I don't want to eat a ghost chili pepper.
All right, the gloves are off. Fair enough.
Hey, what's up, guys? TheCampingRusher here. Welcome back to Factions, everybody. And thank you so much for tuning into this show every single day. Today's a good day. Today, you're going to have lots of random things happening. Lots of, I feel like today is going to be a really good episode. So make sure to stick around, grab yourself some popcorn or a fruit platter, whatever works. And just a reminder to touch that like button if you're excited for today and you're liking the series. You guys have been killing it with the support on this show recently. And I am so very thankful. Thank you so much for being here. You're amazing. And I'm going to start this episode a little differently today. VEMBZ, you're in the call right away here, buddy. How are you?
Good.
You're doing good, VEMBZ. That's what I like to hear, man. Always want to start in a good mood. And we got something special for the viewers today, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we came, I guess we'll start with the daily factions comment of the day, then we'll move to this special thing. Coming in from Finn the Conqueror. Rusher, I just wanted to say that I started watching this show around ep 300, and before then I thought factions was stupid. But ever since then, it is now my favorite game mode, or one of my favorites in Minecraft. And honestly, man, that is awesome to hear. I love that, I guess, my show has turned, your opinion on factions into a fun game mode, because you can definitely make it fun if you get into it, if you, you know, when you meet with the right people, you play with your friends, and you go hard, it can be a really fun time. Very competitive game mode. And even if you don't play and just watch the show, that's awesome too. Thanks again for being here. All right, VEMBZ, are you ready for this, buddy? So basically today, I guess VEMBZ or some of the team came across a fan fiction about VEMBZ. And if you don't know what a fan fiction is, it's like a, I guess fans or viewers, they write a story about a YouTuber, and it's usually pretty intimate, if you know what I mean. Like, they get very detailed. It's usually a love story with a little less love and a little more details, if you know what I mean. So we came across this one today, and I don't actually recommend reading it. I'm gonna keep it pretty PG, but I'm gonna read parts of it. It's like a 40 to 50 page story. And it's about factions. It's about, like, I'll sum it up, because I'm not going to read 50 pages for you here. But it's about VEMBZ and his attraction to an enemy female. And basically how it goes is we're in this big battle, Team Nudis versus this faction who has a girl leader. And they're beating us. This faction is defeating us. This female leader is very strong. And VEMBZ becomes entranced by her. VEMBZ falls in love, and VEMBZ, you just want her, dude. So that's the story, all right, VEMBZ? VEMBZ hasn't read all of it. He read like the first two or three pages and then got old. I've read most of it, and I'm gonna just read a couple parts. And honestly, there's no real reason I'm doing this. It's kind of hilarious. So here we go. Look, I shouldn't be here right now. He pauses. Not with you. And this is VEMBZ talking, of course. she studies him confused. He sighs, knowing she didn't understand. Hellish. And this is the female leader's name is Hellish. He pauses, not sure of what he wanted to do. He takes a deep breath and sighs. He looks at her into her piercing eyes and says, I'm an idiot for doing this. Before she can process what he meant, he pulls her to him and leans in. Their lips collide.
Oh, jeez.
I'm gonna leave it there, man.
Oh my god.
What do you think of that?
Beautiful.
Beautiful, man. Do you want that to happen in real life, or are you cool just keeping it on a factions game mode basis?
faction game.
Yeah, okay. You're not looking for a love life right now.
No.
All right, I got one more thing to read on it. If you guys want to go look it up, you can. I don't recommend it. Fan fictions are usually very, very weird. This one is very weird, but it's actually well written. I got to be honest. Like, there was a lot of time put into this. So this is later on in the story. VEMBZ is starting to kind of work with this girl and go against Team Nudist because he's so in love. So here we go. "I want to help you," he says slowly. She studies him for a second, unconvinced. "What makes you think I need your help?" she spits as her dark side begins to resurface. VEMBZ says, "You need someone to give you information." "All right, we can talk about this later," she says, turning around. But VEMBZ grabs her wrist, making her turn to face him. She realizes how close he is to her. He leans in closer. "Why not now?" And I'll leave it there. Oh, God, that's a nail biter. Oh, VEMBZ, I wonder what will happen next.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, jeez. VEMBZ, do you feel uncomfortable right now?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's it. Again, that was just... This thing's like 50 pages. It would take me like an hour to read, and it would be very inappropriate at some parts. I don't recommend reading it, I don't think. But VEMBZ, I'm glad you were here. I wanted to have you here for the... for the start of this thing, reading a fan fiction about VEMBZ, why not? And yeah, I guess we'll move on. Like I said, we got a pretty cool episode planned for you today. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. VEMBZ and I are moving over to Factions Black to take a peek at something. Of course, probably 3 or 4 days ago, we raided Grape Applesauce. Most of you saw it. It was a crazy double episode, actually, of raiding Grape and Malevolent. And yeah, absolutely fun. One of the most fun times I've had in a while. It was awesome. But they're still there. And a couple things are happening since that raid. That raid kind of triggered the ultimate war. Obviously, there's a war happening. But that raid triggered it to a new level. Ever since then, Grape and Mark have met up. They've started planning. Abusive Admin, their cannon guy, has been scouring our base. They've been patrolling. They've been trying to figure out what they're going to do to get inside. And it's heating up. They're coming. And they're coming fast. So instead of just doing defense, we're doing a ton of defense. You know, Napkin's main job, I guess, right now is basically defending this Black Tree on the Archon, on Crimson. But I thought VEMBZ and I would try something because I heard rumor they're not moving, VEMBZ. They're keeping their base where it is. So that is not a bad thing. But what they're trying to do is to cut off our homes so that we were trapped wherever we go in there and we don't have anywhere to move because they've already taken out the cobble monster. It's completely gone. They must have spent hours doing that or something because that's insane amount of work. That cobble monster was huge. And that was our way of getting a wither over there because I don't think they're going to be using the top parts anymore. Just that bottom bedrock part because they almost have it fully entrenched or surrounded with bedrock, which is very OP. But there's still a little bit left potentially to get inside. But I don't know. I don't really know. Napkin says there's a chance to still raid it. So, VEMBZ, what we're going to do is make sure that our homes are not cut off yet. Because we knew it would come to this. Like, you, me, Napkin, the whole team, we set multiple homes in different places to make sure that if they tried to cut us off, because we knew this could be a possibility, that we would hopefully have a way out. So, I'm going to go to my homes first, and I'll meet you there. All right, bro?
Yeah.
And just be careful, a slash F list, I checked earlier, oh geez, yeah, they have 11 online, so Malevolent, they've got a few online for sure, we just gotta be careful if we get jumped in here, eh? But alright, so my first home is in the top layer here where we first raided, this is Grape's old vault, obviously not usable anymore, and completely cut off. I can't do anything in here, they cut us off, the obsidian all around, that's where we came in with the wither. And there's no way out. So this won't work. But the bigger area, we also set a home there. Home Grape 2, I called it. And this is a big area, obviously. All right, VEMBZ, I'm bringing you in, buddy. Again, just be careful, man. Just be very, very careful. Do you see any names up there or down, I guess, even? I don't think so.
No.
Okay, if we see anyone, we got to get out of here fast, okay? People know we're online. They probably, they always assume we're doing something, so they'll be looking for us. But all right. So this is at the bottom where we did most of the fighting during that raid, and then we dropped down to the potion room. Oh, there's someone down there, bro. There's someone down there. Try and hold shift and get up higher. Yeah. Come on. Yeah, some guy like glue or something. Probably in the bedrock vault or something. But all right, we're going to scour the area. I've been looking around myself, and I think we have a chance. So this is the blaze, I think. This is where we took out the blaze. And I think there's stairs somewhere. Yep, stairs right here. Vems, make sure you got ender pearls, my man. Because we're... Oh, heads up, heads up. Heads up, someone's here. Shift up, shift up. Where are you at? Where are you at, bro? You good? Okay, Vems is muted in the call. And it's just me. And I just saw someone up here. We gotta be careful. I'm trying to... I just speeded in strength. I saw him. He must have TP'd out.
Okay. Oh, sorry, I died.
Oh, no! What?
I went AFK.
Wait, did... Oh, you went AFK?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, dude. They're in the base right now. Oh my god. Okay, up I go. I gotta get up there. This is where I gotta go, guys. Oh yeah, they're all coming. They know we're here, Vems. I gotta hurry up and show these people. So my home is set here right now. But they forget that there's something not covered up. I'm up here. I'm up at the very top now. I have Ender Pearl. Oh, yeah. They're looking for me. They're scanning the base for me, Vems. So you went AFK. Did you have to talk to your family or something?
Yeah, yeah. My mom came in, so I do.
All right, man. Well, that's rough. Okay, well, I think I get to live. There's like four of them down there. If they catch me, I'm dead. I'm just shifting, dude. All right. Go, Rush. Go. So right here. This is, I don't know, I think there's another part open actually too. I don't think they've actually covered up the hole where we first entered in. So that's good. We could have used that as well. But I found this one first when I was scanning the area. If I can make this pearl, there we go. And then I can climb out right here and we are back outside in the malevolent claim and I can set my home anywhere. Now, I'm not going to set my home on camera because, of course, Grape and the enemies can watch my video and they will surround my home. But if you see now, I am on the outskirts of the base. And just to give you another idea, oh, oops, as I missed my ender pearl. Vems is down, so I'm in stealth mode right now. Down there is the bedrock thing, and we're going to do some tests with it in a second. I'm kind of nervous to go down there. So Vems is back now. He's regeared. Yet another kit, my man. Ow! Ow! Whoa, we're not in the same faction, bro. Bro, I gotta invite you. Join my fact. Because, yeah, we may get in a fight. They're all down there. They've logged in another two people. They're all looking for us right now in the base. So we're outside. Vems and I will set different homes and places. They will have no idea, and they won't be able to cut us off. So at least we'll still be able to walk around this base, basically, whether it's up, down, around, who knows. There's multiple places we can set homes. Yeah, there's a lot. They won't be able to cut us off. Now, Vems, one more thing to do, and be careful here. Do you have jelly legs here?
Think so. Yeah, I do.
Oh, God, that was risky. All right. Oh, there's a block there, too. Heads up. Look, keep shifting, dude. Look in the base.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, God, man. Oh, God. All right, let's head down, buddy. Let's head down. Here we go. Alright, so here is, you guys remember, this is the base, the bottom one, that we did not actually get to raid. And it's still got a little bit of obsidian, but it's almost completely surrounded by bedrock. I can 100% guarantee they are still using this thing. No doubt in my mind. Now, Vems, one concern is if this is not a water source ocean, like if it's only source blocks at the top of this ocean... We can spend some time and take a wither to this thing and raid it. Like, it's possible if we, you know, if we could do it this way. But the question is, is this water source? Because if it's, if like, say, guys, there's a source, like, way down here, then it's just going to take hours. Because we have to take up the top layer, the second layer, the third layer. That'll take way longer. Triple every layer that we add onto, it'll take double, triple the time or whatever. So Vems, with that being said, I just want to confirm. I've never done it on video. How do you test if it's water source or not?
You just swim down, and when you like Oh, sorry. Oh, I messed up, dude.
What happened? What happened?
I can't. Wait. My spacebar.
What?
My spacebar.
Oh my god, no, you're falling down?
Yeah.
No, Vams, your spacebar, bro!
Wait, what?
Is your spacebar actually broken?
I don't know, no.
Oh my god, you're gonna die.
Oh, jeez.
You're gonna fall, bro. Slash spawn or something, dude. I can't.
I'm gone.
No, man. Did your spacebar actually just break?
I think something is stuck in here.
Oh my god! All right, guys. Well, Ben's just died.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, man. That was the most depressing thing I've ever watched. You just slowly sank down to your death. Okay, well, his spacebar broke mid-test. So all I do is I click with a right button, and if I pick up water, then it works.
Yeah, if you're underwater, yeah.
All right, here we go.
Oh, it's working now.
Okay, wait, dude, I picked up water, and it didn't go back.
Oh, it's just glitch. It's just lag.
But
if you pick it up, it's water, sir.
But there's no water here now. Like, it's a dry piece here.
Yeah, it's just lag. It's... Yeah.
Like, will it be back when I TP away?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's not gone.
Okay. So, yeah, this isn't this actually is so gone, guys. I just picked it up with my right click or whatever. So, this isn't good, to be honest, ladies and gentlemen. That means that right here, their second layer is water source. Let's go down here. Oh, God. Yep. This whole thing's water source, Vems.
What?
Oh, gee. Well, down here it is, too. Like, that's... That's a lot of layers to go through. Holy God, bro. Alright. With that being said... Oh, jeez. Oh, Gummy's here, dude. Gummy's here. Oh, my God. I don't think he sees me, dude. He doesn't see me. Oh, my God. I actually might kill him in a sec. I'm gonna enderpearl around him. Dude, he does not see me. He TP'd in and he's like AFK or something. I'm gonna try... This is the guy that owner claimed it bad. Oh. Alright, dude, I'm going for it. Oh, he's at 40, 40, 30, 26, no! Oh, God, there's two of them now, Vems, there's two of them.
Oh, jeez.
I'm in some deep trouble here, buddy. I'm going down low, I'm going way low. Oh, actually, then they'll just go above me. Oh, God, Vems. This ain't good, buddy, they found me. So, we've tested what we need to know. Oh, jeez, he bow boosted around me. I didn't get the strength speed kill, and now I'm freaking in trouble, dude. Oh, Dazzle's on the other side, actually, though. I'm freaking drowning. All right, I got a gapple. Okay, so things have heated up a little bit. There are about 10 guys in front of me, and I am pulling, like, the worst, most cheap move in my whole life. Vems just got killed. You can see how many of them there are. There's probably, like, 15 of them here. And what I'm doing is I'm on the world border right now, and when you hit the world border... You can't be hit. It's like enderpearling, I think, or TPing. You can't be hit for a couple seconds. So I am doing the most cheap thing known to man, because if I stop doing this, I will die. There is like nothing I can do. Now, Vems, can I enderpearl though now? Because I haven't been in combat. Like, I haven't been hit in like 2 minutes here. I've just been doing this. Oh, this is terrible.
Yeah.
So you can enderpearl. Have you ever used this strategy before, Vams?
No, but I've seen people done.
Yeah, dude. I don't know if this is illegal on the Archon or not. I hope not. Jeez Louise. Well, regardless, yeah, I don't really know what my plan is here. I guess wait them out. I think my finger's gonna get tired because if I stop, like I said, I'm gonna die. Ladies and gentlemen, I realized this is the only way out. However, I think I wasted about half an hour of their lives. And they wasted a lot of mine, too. I am out of stuff. That's it. I mean, not out of stuff. I'm just like, oh my. There was no way out of there. I was looking at... They were starting literally to wall off that entire bordered area. That would have taken a long time. I think I'll save us all the time. They got a kill. Don't really get anything out of it. Bender from Demonic just said, easy. I'm all right. Vems, we tried. We weren't really online to fight right now, but, you know, if we come online, factions Black and Malevolent, they're looking for some sort of revenge. And if you can't take down Black Tree, well, you go 30v2 against Vems and Brayden. And maybe that will give them some satisfaction. Hopefully it does give them some satisfaction, because then it'll put them off guard and make our job even easier for the next strike. Vems, we've done well. You gotta head out. I got some more stuff to do here for this episode. And I wish I got out of there. I thought I was gonna find a way out, but I just couldn't get anything. So, GG. Well, this is awkward.
Hey, guys.
Hey. How you guys doing?
No, I thought I'd make it awkward by just saying that to start this clip off. So, where am I, dude? I'm in an unfamiliar place. I haven't been here in weeks, man.
My base.
It was your base.
Yeah, it was my base. Sort of.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are on Factions Green right now, the home country of Dylan. And these are your friends?
No.
Oh, they're not. We got Curse Logic and Catnipper. How you guys doing?
I'm fine. All right. I mean, we just raided this base.
Oh, look at that. That's how he starts it off. Confidence is key. So what's the background here? Are you guys both from same faction? We're not too familiar with Green here on my channel. We don't know too much about it. So what's up?
Well, we're actually main allies here on Green.
Okay.
Aftermath and Anonymous.
Okay, you're each in different ones. And you, Dylan, are these like your two main enemies?
Yeah, they are.
Have I fought one of you guys? Like, my clip on Green last time, I feel like I may have fought.
Remember my first base, Brayden? The one that took them 2 weeks to raid?
Yeah.
Yeah, Curse was there. I don't know if you were there, actually, Kat. I think you were.
Yeah, I was.
Okay, yeah, I remember fighting you guys. Okay, so we have met before, just not, you know, talk-to-talk or team-speak-wise, I guess. And now, so Dylan, you moved to a new base. The base that I was in with you got raided. And this base just got raided by these guys right here. Is it unclaimed already and everything? Oh, no.
I think it's still claimed. So pretty much, like, I didn't actually know sort of how it got raided. Like, I had no part in witnessing or even helping to defend the base. It sort of all happened in, like, a little blur. So, like, can you guys explain what happened? Because I'm a bit confused.
I just got told earlier today that one of my guys raided. I don't know how exactly.
Because what I heard is that they had an insider in Cosmic. And what happened is Cosmic didn't actually own or claim their base, so they just cannoned into ours.
So were you were side by side with these guys?
Yeah, we were side by side, yeah. They didn't even need to call a monster because they already, like, were on top of the,
Just didn't want to then. Well, I survived, so,
Did you die?
Go ahead and kill him?
Dylan, I didn't mean to do that, bro.
I only did it because you did it.
Oh, did you shoot him too?
Yeah.
Alright, no, I'm just Cat, I'm just playing, man. No worries.
You sure about that?
Yeah.
Really, no.
So you guys, the reason these guys are in your Catnipper and Curse Logic, you guys tend to get in a lot of verbal fights here on the Archon, on Factions Green. You guys, like, I get in a lot of trash talks with, you know, Manifest, etc., but Dylan and Aftermath and Anonymous, they go hard. So I wanted to meet these guys face-to-face, I guess. So did you live, Catnipper? Did you die, Cat?
No, I didn't.
Dang it!
Oh, God, dude. All right.
It didn't work.
Yo,
Rich,
I don't know
now.
If you want to mess with us, because if you do have lists, you can see how many people we have on.
Yeah, they have a lot of people right now. They have 22 on. There's two of us and 22 of them. Well, with that, boys, I guess that wraps it up. Thanks for being here. It really does mean a lot to me.
Dude. Yo,
boy!
Yo!
And Rusher.
I shouldn't have said I'm on the cobble monster. Uh-oh. Catnip, don't try, buddy.
I didn't bring my axe.
Oh, God! I don't have an axe. Catnip, dude.
Oh.
Be careful here, Dylan. Be careful. I don't have strength or speed.
Take that, Catnip.
Yep.
I will not take that.
Watch out, dude. Watch them TP their guys. Ooh, this is going to be bad for Catnip.
Don't TP your guys. That's kind of bogus.
We won't.
Catnip.
Oh, no. I'm
Catnip.
I'm getting close to the edge.
Catnip, I want to kill you, dude.
Come on, Curse.
Oh, he's dodging my arrows.
Is
like...
Curse down? No.
No, sir.
Why are you TPing your boys here?
Uh-oh. Be careful. Are they TPing the boys in? Be careful.
I told you not to mess with us.
Oh, God. Kill one of them. Dylan, get high, bro. Get high.
We're good.
Come on, Dylan, come on! I got one! Dylan, kill as many as you can before you go. Oh, God, that hurts!
No.
This Justify guy.
Alright, I killed a couple. I'm definitely going down here. Oh, cursed.
Back up.
Cursed, are you there?
Come on.
Yes, sir, bud.
Did he live?
Oh, right, come on.
Oh my god, Curse Freak. Curse, did you die on me there or did you live? Oh, jeez.
No, I'm right here, dude.
Come on.
No, he picked it. He picked it. Oh, baby, there's so many of them.
There's too many.
Dude, Dylan, it's time to give up, buddy.
No. No.
I got Catnipper.
Finish him. Finish Catnipper. Come on.
No.
Oh, your boy's about to go down, dude. All right, I'm done getting kills.
There's
I'm out of here.
Too many of them.
Too
many.
I know, dude. I hear that. Oh, jeez. All right, I'm going in hidden mode.
Oh, god.
Dude, you can't find what you can't. Oh, they see me though. I was gonna say you can't find what you can't
right
see,
here,
but they can see me.
There's like 1,000 of them.
Oh.
Holy god.
Oh, that hurts. Dylan, you're dead?
Yeah, I'm dead.
All right, dude. Well, you actually gave me all this armor, so I'm gonna get it out of here for you alive. All
right, dude.
Can I out bow boost two of these guys is the question. Curse is the one behind me. It's literally you versus me, Curse. The rest of your guys are gone. Don't miss a bow. Every bow shot you miss, dude, is me getting a little bit further ahead. There's definitely a roof on this thing that I was not aware of. Man, this is like a horror film from this perspective. I'm going down. Two men are above me, and I'm trapped,
okay,
man.
You get here.
Thank God you can't drown in lava. Ah! Oh, Dylan, help.
I can't, dude.
I know, that's the thing. Well, we're getting very close to the bottom of the world. It's pitch black. I've never been so scared in my life. I don't have a helmet either. Come on, baby, come on. Can you see me, Curse? Can you see me? It's dark down here, bro. I can't see you. Oh my god, dude. I'm literally seconds away from dying and I don't see them. Curse, give me a confirmation. Do you see me right now?
Nope. Lost.
Yes! It's so dark down here. Is it? I guess it's because the end where... Dylan, I'm literally at like level two. And it's pitch black and you can't see other player names.
Oh my gosh. Can you make it out?
Potentially. I see... I'm way above him now. I see his head.
Oh...
Thanks for telling me, dude.
Who just Your teammate just fell off, dude.
No.
Logic just... Or not logic, but your buddy just fell off the end. Oh, my God. No, I lied
Wait,
to you, Kirst. I saw your feet. I'm not above you, my man.
Alrighty, Brandon. Okay, so you lost him, right?
Well, I mean, he's somewhere in this dark abyss. I don't really know where.
All right, I'm going to TPA here you to me. You may be able to make it out.
Yeah, hurry up, hurry up.
Still.
Do it. I'm burning to death.
I sent it.
TP accept?
Yeah.
I can't when I'm in this block.
Oh, really?
And I'm going to burn to death after all this.
Let him burn.
God, are you serious?
No.
I ran out of god apples. I didn't have a gapple and I burnt to death.
Yes.
Oh,
Rusher
man.
Goes down.
That's just an embarrassment. I made an epic escape through like a hide and seek maneuver and then I freaking burned to death without enough god apples. That, my friends, is why you gotta come more prepared for battle. Jeez Louise.
Well, actually, you should mess with the aftermath.
Oh, there he is. Well, Catnipper, Cursed. We killed a couple of your members. I technically died. Dylan died. And, it was honestly all because of me. I tried to shoot you off. You know, classic cheesy kill by Brain. But there it is. You have a corner base in the end. I didn't know that until now. Thanks for letting me know.
We'll be paying that a visit soon.
Yeah, well, we'll see you around. I gotta come on green a little bit more and see what all the hype is about. So, all right, take care, boys. It was nice meeting you. Two deaths, one episode, slightly embarrassing. I know, you don't have to point it out because I just did. God dang it, man. I don't know. Either way, cool episode, I think. Lots of different stuff happened today, and I really hope you enjoyed. If you did, a reminder to touch that like button for me. It would really mean a lot. And yeah, crate key, let's do it. We can do it, baby. I feel good. Make sure to join the Rush by subscribing, leave a comment down below, and touch that like button. $100 armor kit, we'll take it, baby. And recent 5 donators to the Archon, Low 4, Scotty D4, Gold Monkey Snip Cardus, and JT2000. Thank you for your purchases, the Archon. Good luck on your crate keys and enjoy your ranks. We really appreciate your financial support towards our server. That's it, I guess. That's it. Some huge factions news and stuff. This next week of factions, will be, I mean, emotionally, the biggest week of factions. And gameplay-wise, if things go as I plan, the most surprising and unanticipated stuff is happening this week. So, you know, if you're a fan of the show, make sure you don't miss an episode. I know school's starting up for lots of you soon. Try and still make the time after school if you can jump on. Watch, you know, I'll be starting school as well. I'm starting university next year. But I will still be making a factions episode every single day. So I hope to still see you here all the time, 7 p.m. Eastern. And yeah, I love you guys. Thank you for the support. Have a beautiful night. I will talk to you all tomorrow. Goodbye.